Morning all, it's Lesley here with another video for Indigo Blue. So today we're going to do the man, the phone holder. So we've got these pieces here, which I've already black gessoed with G-So Good Black. We're using this stencil from Indigo Blue. And I'm just going to show you the new collection. We need a bit of card, a bit of corrugated cardboard. So we've got Steamwork Manor, Clockwork Cottage, Wells House, Lady Fortescue, Feltwell Road, and Sir Henry Fortescue. And Sir Henry is the one we're going to use today. So on here, you've got sentiments, you're the man, and an ordinary life can be extraordinary. I'm also using Sizzix framelits from Tim Holtz to do the tag. So that's what we're using. Let's get on and use it. So straight away, we're going to put some texture paste onto the phone holder. So the phone holder stands up like this. So, oops, I'll get the nail file to that. It's a little bit tight, but that goes through there and holds it all up. So this is the bit that's at the front. So this is the bit we're going to decorate. I'll just find the nail file. Make sure it goes in. That over the bin. And I'll just take the knife if I can find it to the hole. There's me, folks. Be back in a minute. Hold it with the scissors. So just take the blade of the scissors and just make sure there's not too much gesso in that hole. A bit more. Should be better. There we are. So I'll clean this up and we'll get going again. Right, so use the nice side. I'm going to put some texture paste through here. So I've got my trusty filthy spatula. And this is True Grit. This is the original one, I haven't got the new one yet. So just like your butter in your bread. To the bottom. Lift off, and there we have it. leave that to dry and pop that back in the pot. Just give that a spritz. Right, so while that's drying, I will warm it up a little bit. I'll just clean off the edges. We'll do the rest of it. So I've got my stamps ready. So this is Sir Henry, very dashing man. And I'm using VersaFine Clear Ink. Lots of light tapping. Make sure he's fully covered. And stamp him down. I'm just going to stand up for this bit to get the pressure. And I've only got a fairly small piece of card because I don't want the whole image. There he is. Perfect. I'll do the sentiments at the same time. I'll do that again. Okay, so I'm just going to heat emboss these. Find my embossing glaze and a piece of paper. The excess. Put the rest back in the pot for later. Quick clean up again. So there he is, Sir Henry, very dashing. Just going back to the phone holder, I'm just going to clear out, you see the little slot there. I just want to take out all of that texture paste. Otherwise the back won't fit. color here, that should help. Make sure it's all clean and tidy. Okay, we'll dry that a little bit. Keep it going. That's pretty much dry now. Okay, so we'll get on with decorating. So we're going to cut out Sir Henry, because all of this image here, you can leave it on. It does fit on the phone holder, but I decided to make him the most prominent. So I've cut him out. And it looks like this. So to decorate on here, I've also used some corrugated paper. So this is just a box, just a cardboard box that's been delivered. Pretty much like what happened before, really. And we're going to use these edges. So all we do is rip down. As much as you want, decide where you're going to put it. So we'll put that on that side. A bit more. I'll put that one right to this, right to that edge, I think. Need that now, and I'll just stick that on with a bit of grab and go glue. Got lots of texture going on. I need a new bottle of glue, I think. Anyway, it'll do for this one. Leave that to dry for a little bit over there, and we'll concentrate on Sir Henry. Okay, so pop my glue upside down. Might last a little bit longer. So Sir Henry, I'm going to do in teals and greens. So the paint I've got here is Viridian Blue, which is a gorgeous colour. Tiny little bit. And lots of water. Mix it up. There we are. Put the lid back on. I'm also going to use some lime marmalade. And lots of water. these paints last an incredibly long time. I've done loads of painting with these and it's still only halfway down the pot. Okay, I'm also going to use some hot cocoa, I think, which is a lovely matte brown. There again, you can still mix it down with lots of water. What else should I use? Red oxide. I will, just as a little bit of a contrast. So I've used a mix of translucent paints and matte paints here. I might just grab a little bit of Tiger Lily too. There we are, just a little bit. That'll do for now. I'll get some painting done. So I'm going to take a little bit of Viridian Blue and start on his sleeves here. Because we've dry embossed it, it's all resist. So you're just going to paint in the bits that are still white, really. It's really easy to colour in. His collar. I'm going to add some eye marmalade. Just to contrast. Just keep building up your colour. If your paints are still wet, then you get a lovely blend. Some of that off there. it's kind of got a cape on here, so I'm going to do that with the lime marmalade. I'm going to dab off a bit of that paint there. Okay. The lime marmalade on here, and then I'm going to come in with another colour. Do the lime for his waistcoat. Whoops, didn't blend out very well. I'm going to do a little bit of orange, which this is Tiger Lily, for the stone in his cravat. And I'll do his cravat in red oxide. So, for the edge, I'm going to use a little bit of this hot cocoa. And the same, I think, on his hat. So I'll just turn him round. I'm coming in from the sides and then just blending with water across the middle. On the brim and his hair. I'm going to go back to the Viridian blue. Do his hat band to tie it in with his coat. There we are, it's nearly done. Right, I'm just going to take, I suppose I could do it with hot cocoa, but I'm just going to take a little bit of walnut stain distress ink. A light wash over his face. those shadows, and then more water. Just dab that off. It's too wet. And then a little bit of red oxide for his lips. A little bit more. And a little bit of colour. I think he'll do. So he's going to go on there, and it looks like when it's all put together, it looks like his arms, which are down here, are holding the little bit here that sticks out. So we need to paint that as well. So I'll put him to one side to dry, and we'll concentrate on this bit. Right, so for this, I'm going to use some metallic paints. So similar colours, actually. So I've got lime sherbet. This is a gorgeous lime green. Kingfisher, which is a fabulous blue, just mix these up with water again. They're incredibly concentrated, and a little goes a very long way, so we should have all that we need there. And I've got a little bit of Merlin, which is a darker blue. Put that one over here. And we're going to use some red oxide. So this is just a translucent paint. Might be some more in the mix by we get going, but anyway, we'll start with that. Okay, so I'm just going to go over and just cover it. Paint wherever you feel like it. A little bit of hot cocoa. We're going to put this on in layers, so we'll dry a bit, paint a bit. We'll have a bit of black as well. Just give that a wash. trusted black gesso here. Have a little bit of that. I'm going to water it down. Just sketchily painting it across. Right down to the bottom. There we are, give it a bit more dry. Put a bit of metallic on it. With a bit of Merlin, that's a bit of a darker colour. You can see I'm certainly not being precise about where I put any of my colours. So I'll lighten that up a bit. Okay, I want a little bit more red oxide in the background here. So I think this time I'm just going to use it neat. I'll have a bit of rusty floor. And a bit more so this is Kingfisher blue, and I'm just gonna do a little bit neat this time. Let's just dry that red oxide. just going around the edges really. Well, wherever you feel like. You can see this blue really shines. So lovely. Right, so I need to remember to work on this bit as well. And the edges, because the edges are the bit that's going to really show. Got a news alert. I'm also going to paint this because this is going to the back, but when you take it apart, you will see it. Careful not to put too much on the edges. I might need to sand them back a bit. So paint it all in this blue, but really sketchily. And then I'll add some more colour. Give that a quick dry. Just spritz my fingers. And then we'll add some lime sherbet. So I'll change to a different brush. I'm almost dry brushing over the top of it. Need to wipe that off though. That won't do any good. A little bit of red oxide, I think. down a bit. Right. Bit more lime sherbet. Get some green in here. There we go. Yeah, it brightens it up. Oxide. And next, gilding gum. Oops, just a little dribble in there, and I've got some bronze luscious. Awesome little spatula, there we go. Just take a little bit and mix it in. There you go. So when it's all mixed, you've got like this alchemy happens, and it's wonderful. Right, so time to get my fingers in. Worth persevering, getting all your layers and colours. Quite cool. Okay. A little bit on the edges of here. And even though you can't really put any texture on here, you've got a variety of colours. So it does look interesting. finger painting. Right, I'll dry this. Can still get it through that hole. There we are. Tight, but it's in. So that's our phone holder. So next thing, I'll put Sir Henry on. I probably need to just, please excuse me, I'll just wash my fingers a minute. Otherwise we're going to make a mess of Sir Henry. Alright, that's a bit better. Pop that to one side. Just give it a bit of a spritz. Trusty yellow mat and a ball embossing tail. Oh, we've made a mess with Sir Henry already. Okay, I'll just redo his hat. Nope, I will manage that. Rescue, a little bit of paint. Should be fine. Okay, so I'm just going to go around the edge of Sir Henry with some black paint. Just from the back. So all the edges are coloured in. It's a fairly easy shape, so just takes a few seconds. So just on the back of him, large ball embossing tool, round and round on the back. That just gives him some dimension. Then you can use either foam pads or silicone glue or whatever you want. I've got this one. This is just colour 3D glue and it's bunged up as usual. I'll just try and get that out. Turn him over. So you can use super thick Slapiton for this, but it takes a little while to dry, whereas this is a little bit quicker. When you can get it out the tube. There we are. That should be enough. Just spread it out a little bit. Because you've shaped him, you shouldn't be any edges showing. So basically, get your phone holder, pop him on the front. Stick him down. And 3D glue should hold in the depth because you've got quite a bit of depth here. So it just means that he's got something to sink into. Right, we need to put his sentiments on. So I've got a ticket here that says, "You're the man." So that's going to go across there, but under his hat. And then we stamped a sentiment somewhere. Oh, it was on, there we go. It scissors. Can't find the scissors. Anyway, never mind, these will do. Cut that off the top. I'll just get my guillotine. Just cut the message up. And so there we have it. So we've got an ordinary life can be extraordinary. That's some rubbish. Right, so I'll cut this down. And I'm going to pop that under here. So we're going like this. So I'll cut that down a little bit more. Get rid of all this rubbish. Trusty blending tool and some distress ink. So I'm using walnut stain again. Just take the colour off, take the whiteness off, I should say. into my fingers. Same with the ticket. It's this matte, I think. Everything sticks to it. And go on the back of the ticket. As I say, that just pops under his hat. Hold it down to stick. And then a little bit on the back of here. Just hold it for a few seconds. Helps if you get it the right way up. Okay, here we go. Ordinary life can be extraordinary. Right, lift that. Hold it in place. And there we go. Pop the lid on here. I hope you've enjoyed it and hope you get to make your own. So the blanks for the phone holders are available on the Indigo Blue website. You should probably really decorate the back, but I think it's quite cool. Hope you like it. Thanks for watching. I'll see you again soon. Bye-bye for now.